This is PLUS TV Africa's Tea Time, and we're here to serve tea. I am Ife Oshunkeye, and joining me is CC the Ginger.
The Ginger.
If you're a Terry G, you'll be with your bill. When you hear that ginger.
It's just that what is inside this, under this wig, is scary. If not, I would have put off and show you the real
Terry. Is it scary, though?
Very scary.
That's your level of intelligence,
right? It's even more dreaded than Terry G's dread.
No, I mean, okay, punchline. I was even trying to make it subtle, but she just made it. All right, it's all good. It's all good. How you doing, though?
I'm good. I'm
good.
Great,
yeah?
To be here.
How's your day been?
A bit hectic, but it's been cool.
Nothing we can handle, right?
Nothing we can handle.
If we can beat COVID-19, we haven't won yet, but we're winning. We
when you say beat COVID-19, it's as if I had COVID-19 and I'm fighting it, though. We can beat COVID-19 as Nigeria. So it doesn't look like.
But it's all good. First up on our lineup, you know how we do it. We spill the tea and then we dissect it out here. And first up on the lineup is a saying by a Twitter user who said the only award Whiskey that's not won in Africa is Best Female Artist. And this is coming from Jaswil OG.
And agreed. I was like, is that are you sure that's not a subtle shade?
No, because it's not a shade. I think it's more of a stand.
Awards, the awards that Whiskey hasn't won. I'm
give
sorry.
Me one. In Africa.
In Africa. Now I get it.
Yeah.
Now I get it. Yes.
He's won every award in Africa. I went back to check it. He has won every single award in Africa.
I mean,
and he's probably never going to win at Female Artist of the Year. He's probably never.
Well, you know something can happen. I mean, we have Babriske.
Okay, so you think Whiskey at some points may become transgender?
Just go, Shay, we're scared. In the building.
I don't even want to picture that. Whiskey, whatever you do, please do not do that.
But he just dropped the
smile video. Very amazing. And then, I like the fact you brought that up because a lot of people, you know, this is telling people that before you jump the gun, at least let them show you what's actually behind it, right?
Yeah.
Because a lot of people, when they saw the picture where he lifted up his last son, right? And they started saying that Whiskey showcases only the boy, not knowing that it was a video shoot and all his kids were in the video.
All his kids
so sometimes
there,
don't
so
jump into conclusions.
People need to be
calming down like this.
You have to be calming down.
They have to be calming down.
It was such a gorgeous video. I love
video.
The fact that
it made me smile.
He brought that part of his family into the video. If you know, Whiskey isn't somebody who is so out there, although he posts his children on the social media, but when it comes to his music, he hardly add them into the whole picture. But this time around, we got to see, you know, his family, that sweet side of him. So this is Whiz Daddy.
Yeah.
No longer
in case you haven't seen it, you need to go check it out. Smile by Whiskey. It's on all platforms already, and it's really, really amazing.
Yeah.
And we need to move on to the next story. And this one is Sade Ladipo.
We'll the say Queen of Shade.
Okay. Sade Shade. Okay. If someone promises you money or gift and fails to fulfill that, please understand it's just a promise. You have no rights to the money. You have no entitlement to the money. The money isn't yours. The money belongs to the owner. Let's stop being beggars here.
I think, are you sure she's not throwing shade at
obviously,
Erica?
There's a beggar in her.
Are you sure it's not Erica?
Yeah, because in that same tweet, right? Hashtag Erica make more t-shirts. Erica sell more t-shirts and stuff like that.
It's definitely directed towards Erica. And there is one thing is that I've actually worked very closely with Sade Ladipo, and nobody knows from where she's thinking from. Nobody just knows where she's drawing these words out from. But there is one thing I know is that she doesn't do things to chase clout. She sees things and she just, like, I have an opinion about it. I'm just going to put it out there. Just that like the media always goes there and grabs it out and put it out there and everybody be like, oh,
but
she's chasing
clout. It makes a lot of sense that this is Erica because actually there's a sense of it. I went back to watch the video from the guy. I think there's some level of sense of entitlement in that video where you feel like they feel like they're old. Somebody promised you. Yes, it's okay. I know we dissected this morning.
Yeah.
And we saw it from a different light. But now that Sade is doing this, I think she makes a lot of sense to that. I think something should be handled privately.
Well, I still believe that there are always two sides to a story. It depends on how it rubs off on you.
So Mike needs to come and tell us his own side of the story.
Who?
Mike, the guy who promised that a car.
He has come out to shout now. Have you not seen all the...
Tell me about that.
All the back-to-back. He has come out to say, who's that guy that came out to speak? He doesn't even earn as much as my driver, as much as my dry cleaner. You know how they go, blah, 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 blah. And he went on to say that the car was already almost in Nigeria, that he was already shipping it down to Nigeria, that he was, they were just being impatient. Wow. That he never said he wasn't going to give her the balance 1.5 million, but that after they've signed the contract, and people were like, you never said it was all about a contract in the first place. Mm. I mean, if you had said that, maybe they won't have calculated it to the $45,000 that they've raised for Erica, because I believe by now they'll say, okay, we have 2 extra million naira to add.
Yeah.
This is how much she's made. Yeah. But now it's all under the carpet because you wanted her. And you see some of these deals they sign. Brother, if you read some of the terms, it's crazy. I think I was close to one of the ex-Big Brother Nigel Smith. She had a deal with a hair, whatever, I don't know what. But if you see the list of what she had to do, and you think they paid them so... You think they pay them so high. Mm. But bro, those deals are like 2 million, 1.5 billion, highest 3 million.
And then they expect you to do so much.
Forever. It's a forever living product.
I can just imagine. Mm-hmm. But whatever Shade Ladipo is shading, one thing we can all agree with is that there's a begging culture in this part of the world. We can all
please,
agree to
see,
that.
See one line, please. My brother is just very sick. He wants to die now. I just need 1,000 naira to buy him food. And then comment under that.
In as much as that is funny, but sometimes these cases are true. So help when you can.
And you have data.
And when you can't help, it's okay to say you don't have. You never know. Somebody can buy you data. It's easy. These networks make it easy.
I'm hungry. You're not using the money to buy me data. Bros, give me the money. If you know it's 100 naira, give me. I will buy bread.
Well, that won't stop people that still want to help from helping. So if you're feeling helpy, please do.
Please,
if you're being feeling generous, please do.
Okay.
If you're feeling nice, please do. But at the end of the day, the begging
nice
culture is still there. Yeah, if you want
to
feel nice to...
As in,
I want to feel nice?
Don't you want to be nice to me?
Okay.
Don't you want
to be nice to you
with me
during this break at tea time? We'll be right back. In case we don't come back, you know what we're up to, right?